Hi everyone, Damien Vate here, and welcome back to Besiege. We're still on the first world, Ypsilon, and we're on zone 11, so we're going to jump right back into where we left off last time. So this one I need to destroy the tower, so to do that, I don't think any of my previous vehicles are going to work, especially not the cannon one, because the cannonballs actually just bounced right off it. So I need to make some sort of catapult, I think, so that's what I'm going to do today. So let's go ahead and start making a frame for it. Let's get the wood pieces out here. I'm gonna make sure. I might need it to have wheels so I can angle it, maybe? I don't know. Maybe if I just make it more towards the left, then it will work, but it depends how wide it's gonna need to be. I need to destroy 80% of the tower, so I might need more than one projectile, in which case I'm gonna need wheels so that I can angle it. Oh, wait, no, I can't. I can just rotate it, can't I, with this thing here? Ah, okay, cool. No wheels are gonna be necessary for this. So let's go ahead and, I guess, just make a base for the catapult to sit on. I'm going to make it nice and wide. I'll probably have, like, three little catapults I can fire individually. Or maybe fire them all at the same time, if it's going to work. okay, let's see how to do this. I actually don't really know how to make a catapult. I know you saw my attempts at one yesterday, I think. I think I attempted to make one yesterday. It didn't go very well. But I did look up a video and it showed how to use the strings properly. The elastic string. So you can fire stuff with that. And hopefully I can get that to work. I'm just making a nice big base right now. I don't really know exactly how big I'm going to need to make it. Let's get another one piece here. Okay, that's probably going to be big enough. Now let's put a thing in the middle. For the catapult arm to sit on, and we're gonna see how wide that's gonna need to be, and then I'll make the base wider if I need to. Oh, I didn't want to do that. So I'm gonna use the, not the steering hinge, but the other hinge. Where is that at? Locomotion? Oh, it's just here. Okay. Now, this is the hinge that sort of flops to one side depending on which side is heavier. So we're gonna give it an arm on top. Let's do a small wooden block here. Oh, it's too high. That's okay, because I don't need wheels, so I can drop it to the ground. Okay, here we go. Let's give it this here. Nice longer arm on the back. So now if I press play, it tilts backwards. Although it's smashing on the ground, that's probably not a good thing. I might want it to sit on the base. Otherwise, it might explode. Because those bombs are quite volatile. Okay, let's see. Yay! Okay, and we'll put a bomb holder on it, which is with the weapons. There it is. Put the bomb holder and a bomb. Alright, awesome. Let's see if that stays in it. It does! Cool. Alright, so the next thing we need to do is to have some strings attached to the front, the elastic ones, so when you pull the strings, it'll fling the arm up and hopefully throw the bomb in the right place. I don't know if the strings need to be a little bit more forward or if it'll work where they are right now. Let's see, where's the string at? Is that in mechanical? Spring, that was it, yeah. I don't know why I was calling it string. Okay, so I need to pop this down here like that. And do the same on the other side. Let's give this a quick test. What was it I had to press for that? L. Okay, so if I press L, it should fire it. Oh my! I think he just fired it straight up in the air. Let me try that again. What? Oh dear. You know what? It might be because I have no braces on it, so it's not nice and stiff. It's all wonky and wobbly, so it's falling all over the place. Let's put some braces on. And that should make it strong enough so that it just goes straight forwards. Let's try. Get some braces underneath it. So now that will act like a nice solid piece. Maybe I need some braces down here too. Definitely don't want this wobbling. Let's see. Let's just try this out. Oh! Oh my gosh, I won! I destroyed the entire thing! Well, that was nice and easy. Well, there you go. That's how you make a catapult, I guess. I didn't quite need it to be as wide as I did make it. I was thinking I might need, like, three bombs or something, but nope. One will do. Fantastic. Let's go to the next zone. Oh, what is this? Steal and deliver one wood pile. Hint, grabber. Oh, okay, so we're gonna need some sort of vehicle that can pick up the wood and then place it in a higher location. That's gonna be kind of tricky. Let's save our catapult here because I might need to go back to it for something else later. And then we're gonna load up the dirt machine because that's got wheels and everything. So that's gonna help. Oh, there we go. I just had to double click it. It's also got a lot of extra weapons on it, which we're not gonna need any weapons at all for this one, actually. So we're gonna go ahead and erase some of these blocks here. No need to have it more complicated than it already is. And then, I wonder if I could use that scooper somehow to do it. Nah. It definitely says use a grabber. Okay, so that's what we're gonna use. Scared of all this stuff. Okay, so we got our nice basic vehicle, which totally controls so awesome. It's the worst. But that's okay. We only need to get a piece of wood. We don't need to fight anybody, so it doesn't matter that it's kind of weak. So let's get a grabber of sorts. I might need to move the machine backwards, actually, so they can make a grabber arm in front. What if I need to make it hinge or something? Maybe. I'm such a noob at this that I don't really know exactly how I'm gonna have to do these things. A steering hinge? No. Did I ever find anything that would just let me turn angle something one way or another? I know the steering hinge would probably do that, but I need that for my wheels. Piston, spinning block. Oh, there's a grabber. That's what I need. Let's go with. Where's the steering hinge gone? I lost it already. ball joint, swivel joint, half pipe, brace, steering hinge. Okay, let's put the steering hinge up here. And then I think you can press F to rotate it somehow. Oh, that's just doing left and right. I want to do up and down. Let me have a look at the controls or something. Maybe G? D? No. R? Ah! Did you see that? Oh, all right, I know what I need to do. There we go. So apparently, if you press R, it changes the rotation. That's good to know. I could have used that tip when I was working on my flying machine to rotate the wings. Oh well. So let's go ahead and make sure that this does a different input rather than left and right. We're gonna do maybe the arrow keys, the number pad. Yeah. Okay. Let's try that out real quick. So if we do this. Ah, so I can tilt the arm down to grab it and then pick it back up so I can pop it on this higher platform. Fantastic. That works really well. Okay. So let's go ahead and make the grabbing arm. I'm going to need some wood blocks. Pop this one here like this. Nice long grabbing arm. Probably going to need a counterweight as well on the back. Just because it might not lift it if it's too heavy. I don't know how heavy it's going to be. Actually, I wonder if I should put. Ah, no. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it. I was thinking I might need to put like springs on the back of it so I could pull those in to bring the arm back up, but I might not need those, so I'm not going to worry about it just yet. Let's just make sure this is nice and strong because it looks super weak. Oh, you know what? That would help right there. Put some of these. Yeah. Awesome. All right, now let's just get a grabber, which is that in weaponry? Grabber, 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 grabber. Where are you at? No, I guess it's mechanical. Here we go, the grabber. Yay. Okay, pop that in front. Now let's have a look at this. Oh, it's very wobbly. Oh my gosh, that's terrible. How is that not stuck? You see, it's like breaking apart right there. Oh well, whatever. Let's go ahead and give it a shot anyway. So go forward, forward, forward. Oh, the arm doesn't turn. That's okay. We go turn like this. That looks pretty good. So if we move this down, oh, the grabber automatically grabbed. Oh, well, that's useful. Okay, we'll tilt this up. Yeah, we got this. Now we just need to safely deliver it. Did I lose a wheel? Oh wait, no, I didn't lose a wheel. Okay, let's safely deliver it like this. Yay! Awesome. That deserves a nice sip of coffee. Let's see what we're gonna do in the next level. Kill 80% of all sheep? What did the sheep do? Oh, that's so sad. What if my little grabbing machine can actually take out the sheep? Let's go. Oh, they're attacking me! Ah! Okay. This should be a piece of cake. I don't even need to make like a cool killing machine for this. I could just use my grabber. Oh. No, the sheep are winning! The sheep are winning! Okay, fine. Should we save the grabber? I don't know if we're gonna need that again. Let's go ahead and save it. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't want to have to make it again if I need it for a later level. So there we go. Grabber version 1. Perfect. And we're gonna load up the killing machine, or rather the derp machine. This should definitely deal with the sheep. Okay. Let's see. What were the controls again? So, cannon, fire! Oh my gosh! Well, there goes half my weaponry. Oh no. What's a flame throwing? Was it V? It wasn't V. Y? Aha! There we go. Oh, they're too high for the sheep. I thought they were on the bottom. Okay, the front of my machine is gone. Okay. This just means that we need to make a very special sheep killing machine. So let's go ahead and make a nice little base. I think I might try a different way of doing the steering, because the front of that machine just kept breaking off all the time. It was no good. What if I had. I want a spinning blade. That's what I want in this one. I want a nice big spinning blade. Maybe I can make it kind of like a lawnmower or something, so there's a big spinning blade right underneath, and then the wheels are off to the side. So I could just like ride over a sheep, and any sheep in the middle will just get minced up. That could be pretty fun. Let's try that. Okay, so let's go to mechanical. Let's get the spinning block right there. Okay. Maybe I should put one on top as well, just in case any sheep get on top of the machine. Nah. I probably need that for cannons or something to get up there. So okay, we got a spinning block. Let's get the blades on so we know how wide it's gonna have to be. Okay. This is gonna be great. I already know this is gonna be really good. Okay, and we need this. The steering might be a little bit tricky on this one. Maybe if I had some of the wheels going one direction and the other wheels going another direction, like if I split the controls up or something, so I can make one side go forward and one side go backwards, so I can actually turn on the spot. That could work pretty well. Are the wheels gonna be safe if I put them here? They're probably gonna get chopped by the blade, aren't they? So I need them to be a little bit further out. That should probably do it. Okay, and let's make sure we've got some nice strong things going across here. I do need to connect it. There's a little gap there. We can't have gaps. Okay, like that. Let me think. I think the wheels will be fine there. So how do I go about changing the wheels? Oh, we could do large wheels. Oh, you know what? We are definitely going to need to do large wheels because otherwise the spinning blade will be touching the ground. I didn't think about that. Let's get a wooden block here. Let's just try this as it is right now and just make sure that the spinning blades don't chop the sides. Oh, they won't spin because it's on the floor. Okay, well, yeah, that makes sense. That makes sense. Okay, let's move it back up then. Move it back up, and we can just put the wheels on the lower blocks as they are right now. So locomotion. We'll do the big wheels. Oh, look at that! They got giant spikes on them too. That is pretty cool. Okay, let's take a look at this. Oh, the spinning blade works! Look at that! That's gonna be so cool. Oh, my game minimized. Why did you do that? Get back up here. All right, sorry about that. My game was being weird. So let's go to the controls here. And so up and down, we're gonna have to change that. So let's have forwards be up on the number pad and reverse be back on the number pad. Let's just try that out real quick. So I use forward and 8, backwards and 2. But then if I do backwards and 8, it should spin. Ha ha ha! Yes! Okay, it's a little bit weird to control it like that, but it looks like it should work. Oh my gosh. Okay, it's not quite ready yet. We need to make it stronger because these sheep actually seem to clog up the wheels or something crazy. And we probably need some other weapons on it as well. So let's get some flamethrowers. We can put the flamethrowers actually on every side in the middle. As long as they're shooting out, I think we'll be fine. So let's go to the weapons again. We'll get the flamethrower. Nice. Yeah, that should work pretty well, I think. But what we need to deal with is the sheep that are up on the hill. I'm not really sure this thing's going to drive up a hill very well. So we're going to need to make sure we have some sort of cannons as well. Maybe a bomb or something? A flaming ball? I'm a little bit worried about the flaming ball because that might set me on fire. In fact, it's probably quite likely to set me on fire. But maybe I could make a catapult on top of this, as well as some cannons. Oh, you know what? I'm probably just getting ahead of myself. Let's go ahead and just do the cannons for now. Because if I go and make the catapult, I'm probably not going to need it. Because I could get lucky with the cannon shots. Let's put these here. Da-da-da-da. Okay, that's nice and strong looking. Let's get some braces on top. Want to make sure that we don't fall apart. Falling apart would be pretty bad. Oh, look at that. You can cross the braces too. I actually didn't know you could do that. I just figured I'd give it a shot. That definitely looks like a strong machine. I've got to make sure I do the wheels as well, actually. Don't want to forget those. Because if those wheels break, I am not going anywhere, and I'm not going to be able to beat this. The sheep will win. And that'll be very embarrassing. Okay, I think that should be fine. I think. Yeah, okay. So let's get some cannons on top of it then. I'm going to use the hinge thing like I did before, so this kind of angle upwards a bit, rather than firing straight forwards, because I'm going to need to angle upwards to hit those sheep up there. So let's get some single blocks here. I'm going to pop them right next to each other. I think I can have the cannons right next to each other. Is it going to let me? Aha. Okay. I'm going to have a lot of cannons on this, but I'm actually going to individually map them, I think. So like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'll do the number keys for that. That should work pretty well, I think. Let's get some hinges on top. Okay, and these again. Ooh, hopefully this isn't going to angle too high. It might actually angle a bit too high. Let's see. Let's simulate that. Yeah, those do angle up a bit much, don't they? How would I fix that? Oh, you know what? I could put some blocks down here for it to land on top of. Just put one here. And then make sure some blocks go across like this. And now they should sit on that, I think. Aha! Okay, they don't go as high. Awesome. Did I see a bit of slowdown when I was doing that? Oh my gosh, these things. They're not quite heavy enough. But once I get the cannon on there, they will be. Let's quickly do some braces, though. To make them just a little bit... Uh-oh. Well, those braces kind of went off to the side there. That was a bit weird. Okay. This might be overkill. It might be way too much. Yeah, it probably is way too much. These, actually, I can tie together because they're not going to move. And these ones here. Like that. Braces on everything. I love how easy the building is in this game. Like, just clicking and dragging like that. They did a really good job on the building. Oh, okay, so now we need the cannons. Let's see, regular cannon. Just pop it on the back like this. Right here. Oh, I missed it. They've all got to be aligned. We can't have it looking silly now. Okay, so let's do number one for that, two for that, three for that, four, five, six, seven. Awesome. That's cool. Let's quickly try that out. Oof, laggy. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. That's so cool. Oh, they fire really far though, so I'll have to make sure that I back up from the sheep. Okay, awesome. Let's, I think we're ready to give this a try, actually. What were the flamethrower controls? I forgot. I always forget what those are. Those are Y, weren't they? Okay. Let's give it a shot. I'm gonna go back. What the heck? I think there's a brace on my wheel. The brace is on my wheels. Okay, we're gonna have to get rid of those. I can't have those swinging around everywhere. There we go. Okay. Now I'm ready. So, let's go forwards. Get these guys here. Oh, it's actually a little bit laggy. Oh, I guess I have too much stuff on my machine. I think you can slow down the simulation speed for that. Actually, let's get the flamethrowers out real quick. if I slow down the simulation, it will be less choppy. Yeah, there we go. Everything's moving a little bit slower, but it's not laggy, so that's great. Let's turn around here. Wish my camera would turn around with it. Need to get these guys all in the fields. Okay, like that. And hopefully we can burn down the fence, because I don't think we're going to survive running into it. Are my flamethrowers already used up? I actually thought those fired forever. I guess not. Okay, go backwards, backwards, backwards. Don't smash into the tree. The nice spinning blades work in there. Okay, let's go this way. We'll get these guys. We're doing pretty well. We might not actually need to get the people that are on, not the people, but the sheep on top of the hill. If I can get all these guys down here. Oh my gosh. Just carnage. I think actually most of them are dying to my wheels rather than the spinning blades. But it was a nice idea. Oh dear. Okay. I don't actually want to kill all the ones on the ground. I want to get the ones on the hill. So let's turn ourselves around here. If I can figure out how to do that. Here we go. It's working. It's a bit difficult to control it with the way that I did set it up, but it's definitely working. So now we have to get a nice straight path onto that hill so that we can kill the sheeps. Let's turn the right way, like that. Oh, I think the aim is just a little bit off. Okay. Alright, let's do one warning shot here. Is it going to hit any of them? Oh, first try. Well, let's celebrate with firing the rest of the cannons! Woohoo! Oh, that is so cool. Alright, next zone. I think I put a little bit too much on that machine, though. It got a bit laggy. What is this one? I just need to pass through the areas. Ah. Well, let's go ahead and save this machine again. This is the, what would we call this? The lawnmower. I don't think it's going to get very far up there with all these cannons, and it doesn't look like I need to shoot anything, so I could probably just get rid of all the cannons. Let's get rid of all these. And all this, and all the braces. And then we could just go straight up the hill and complete the objective. As long as the vehicle actually can survive the drop, because it did look like there was a drop on the other side of that thing. A little bit worried about that. Okay. So let's go. Oh, I'm using the wrong controls here. I was moving the camera. Oh! Oh, there's people shooting at me! Hey, I haven't done anything wrong! I haven't done anything wrong yet! Okay. here we go. Oh, this thing is, like, very difficult to control, though. I suppose I don't need to rush it. Oh, I'm too wide! Oh, you gotta believe! Fine. Fine. At least I took all those guys out. Oh, did I hit a bomb? I did hit a bomb. Okay. We could just do this better this time. So let's rotate here. Go forwards. I should be fine. Nah, I'm just too wide. It's too wide of a machine. Okay. Let's go ahead and make something smaller then. We'll start from scratch. It's probably easier to do than deleting all the things that I had there. So I guess the main thing here is to make sure that I can survive both an onslaught from the archers and then also the drop that's going to happen on the other end. Maybe if I made myself fly a little bit, that could be good. Do I think? I don't think being very long is going to help me here. It's going to make it harder to control. So I'm going to make a sort of s short, stocky machine that's all about mobility. Speaking of, I'm going to have to figure out how to do the steering again, aren't I? What if I do a steering hinge like this here? Let's do the F key. Is that right? Let me just try this out real quick. Oh, it's kind of like it's swimming. Oh, that's funny. So let's put this down again. Let's see. So if I do left and right. Okay. That could work. As long as I don't steer too much, I think, then I should be fine. But I could actually put wheels on all of them, I think. Would that work? I don't know if that would actually turn me or not. I don't think that would actually turn me at all. Let's pop these here. We get some nice big wheels so that we're good and sturdy. Like this. Yeah. Is that too wide again? Did I make myself too wide? Let me check this out real quick. It does not turn very well at all. Oh, that's probably the worst turning I've ever seen. What is that? Okay, whatever. Get rid of that. Let's try again. There's got to be a better way to turn. What is this thing here? That's the steering. Okay. Steering and then steering hinge. Oh, so there's two different things. I was unaware of that. Let's try again, and we'll make ourselves a little bit thinner so we're not so fat this time. We'll do little one pieces like this. We're gonna be just a nice little bug, nice and cute. So steering. Where, oh, I lost it already. Where was it? Oh, here it is. Okay. I'm gonna pop these out and we're gonna see what they look like when I move. Oh! Oh, so this is more for like a slow turn. They don't go forwards or backwards though. I don't know how that's gonna work with a wheel. Let's put wheels on it and just check it out. Oh, look at that. I'm still so wired. Maybe it's because I'm using large wheels. Let's see. So forwards and backwards, that works as expected. Let's get out of the way of these stupid archers here. And if I turn it. Oh, so it's like turning on the spot. Oh, but they do turn quite nicely. And the benefit of these ones is that because it's not a hinge, it's not going to turn too far and then break off. So actually, that's pretty good. They're a little bit slow for turning, which is the only problem. Maybe I can modify that though. Let's see. Rotation speed. Aha! Twice as fast. I like that you can just do that. There we go. Let's try that out real quick. Oh, that's much better. Let's try going up here. This vehicle, obviously, I think the controls are actually reversed from what I would like. So I'm pressing left to turn, and it's going right. Okay, so let's reverse those then. F, 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 F. Okay. There we go. Now it's turning the way that I want it to. It's actually quite zippy too. Just need to make sure you don't fall off the edge. Oh my gosh, that scared me. Okay, so what I can actually do here is I can get rid of these blocks that they're attached to and just move the steering things in further because there's no need for them to be sticking out like that. And I think the wheels will still be fine. Let's do a steering kit. Intersection. You're an intersection. Fine. I guess I can do that. So let's go back to what we had. I'm just worried it's really wide. Why is it so wide? Is it the wheels I'm using? Let's try a small wheel here. Motor wheel. Okay. Oh, the wheels also turn with the key presses. Oh, that's right. That's right. Well, it's definitely less wide. Let's give it a shot. I don't want to put a wheel there. Okay. Okay, put a wheel here, a wheel here, a wheel here. Let's just try out the mobility here. So, forwards and backwards works as expected. The turning still works, so that's good. Definitely not as wide. Oh my gosh, this is scary. So scary. I lost a wheel. I think this is gonna work better though. So what I need to do now is just make sure that nothing falls off. So I need to make myself nice and armored. So let's get not that. Wooden panels, there we go. Are these good as good as armor? Let's see. Oh wait, no, here's armor. Metal plates. Heat resistance and piercing resistance. And a plow. I don't think the plow's really gonna help me right now. But let's go ahead and put the metal plates all over this thing. So we're nice and strong, so they can't shoot everything off with their arrows, which doesn't even make sense if you ask me. Well, let's do the round ones here. Yeah. That definitely works. Okay, let's get some metal plates on the front, like this. And there. And I think I still need braces, so let's get braces in as well. I'm gonna put those on the bottom, though. Like that. And here. And one here. Okay, can I put braces on top of the metal plates, too? I probably should have checked that first. It kind of doesn't look like I can do that. So yeah, I think this should be good. Let's give it a shot. As long as they don't shoot off my wheels, I think I can make this. And I'm not in a huge rush, aside from not wanting to get arrowed to death. But there, yes! I made it to the first checkpoint. The second one should be pretty easy to get. All I need to do is fall off the top of this bridge. Oh wait, no! Oh, I need to actually survive up there. My controls are all reversed, I think. Here we go, here we go. I'm upside down. Okay, so I don't even need to do it in order. I just need to make it up the hill now. So that shouldn't be too hard as long as I don't break apart, considering I don't have any armor plating on the bottom of the vehicle. Okay, just to combat these relentless archers. You guys, you're really earning your paycheck. Okay. Come on. Don't fall off the edge. Oh, I lost a wheel. Oh, this is a terrible time to lose a wheel. Oh, no. I lost two wheels. I'm so close. I'm so close to it. Can I just, like, shimmy my way to it? Come on. Shimmy, 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 shimmy. It's not gonna let me shimmy. Okay. Let's just do it again, but not miss this time when we go up the hill. And I think as long as I get up that hill and go off the edge, that will put me on the last checkpoint that I needed to hit. So it shouldn't be a problem. I just need to make sure I don't fall off the edge. This thing is really zippy. But I do like I like the new steering pivots better than the other one, the steering hinge. Here we go! And then I just need to land off the bottom. Yay! I think I've only got one more level left in this entire world that I'm on right now. Let's see, what's this last one? Destroy 60% of everything. Well, this machine is not going to destroy anything. I can run over people, but that's pretty much it. So let's go to the lawnmower? That could work. Oh wait, no, I need a catapult, don't I? Because I need explosive bombs for the castles. Unless there's going to be mines on the ground near it. So maybe I can go ahead and modify the lawnmower design. And instead of having cannons on it, let's go ahead and oh no, we can have some cannons on it, but we need catapults. At least one catapult to deal with the big castle there. Okay. So let's modify this. Let's get rid of the cannons in the middle, I think. And then I should have enough room for the catapult. If I remember how to make it. Okay, like that. Pop these down. Actually, kind of need to rebuild this thing in the middle that the cannons were landing on. Just to have a single block, like that. Okay, let's make the catapult. So, do it about here. In the middle. Is it gonna let me put that block there? There we go. And then I just need a hinge, not a steering hinge. But the other kind of hinge. Where was it? Here it is. Okay, hinge like that. Make it stick out to the front. And definitely out the back. Oh, it lands right on that flamethrower, doesn't it? I don't think I'm gonna need a flamethrower in the back of the machine, though. Okay. Now, what do I do next? I do the bomb. Okay, so the holder and the bomb, like that. Intersection. Oh, it's 'cause it's too high. Here we go. Let me put that in there. Okay, this is going well. This is going well. Now I need the string, or the springs. Put them in the front. Is that right? No, I think it needs to be down like that. I'm worried that's not enough movement. Let's try that out real quick. So L to contract. Zoom. Oh, I got the guys in front of me. You know what I was missing was the braces for the catapult arm. I love how it just collapsed into nothing in the middle of me spinning around. Alright, let's get the braces in here. Like this. Can get it underneath as well. Like that. And just make sure this is nice and sturdy as well. Come on. There we go. Right, that should work as far as the catapult is concerned. Let me just try it out real quick. Fire! It doesn't fire very far. But it's probably going to be enough. I think it's because the arm isn't high enough. I'm not getting enough tension on this string. Although maybe I can make the string go a bit faster. Let me see. Here we go. 10 times! Let's see if that's going to work. That might actually be terrible. And spring! What the heck? Why did you blow upon me? Alright. Let's change the strings back, I think. Oh. No, I want them to be one. Can I just click on here? I can. Times one. Awesome. And then this one. Times one. Perfect. Okay. I am still a little bit concerned that the catapult might actually need to be a block higher. Just get it enough swing. But we'll try it as it is right now. And we'll just kill what we can. Let's go for it. Yes, lawnmower! You're the best! Wait, nope, I need to turn the other way around. Like this. Can I do this? my wheels are so red with the blood of the soldiers. So I need to destroy these buildings as well. The flamethrower is probably going to be best for that. But I don't want to blow myself up. So let's try and be a little bit careful here. I'm going to go over to the windmills on the right hand side. There we go. Ah! Jeez, why? Scared me. They're not allowed to do that. okay, I think I just took too long. Oh, I forgot I've also got the cannons, which would be 1, 2, and 6 and 7, I think, for those ones. So let's try that again. I totally forgot about the cannons, but I can use those to destroy the buildings. I just need to make sure that my bomb doesn't go off by itself. Go away, you. Flames. What? He's still alive. What a lucky guy. There we go. Is he still alive? Really? How are you still alive? There we go. So now I just need to go ahead and shoot those buildings over there. Let's see if this works. Yes! Oh, man. That was such a good shot, too. Let me rotate just a little bit this away. 6. Oh, yeah! Is that not counting? I don't think that I even counted, did it? I'll try 1 and 2 on this building over here. That's a little bit like that. Fire! Oh, no, I missed. I'm a little bit too close to it, I guess. That's the thing with having them at an angle like that. They do go very far. Yes! Oh, that didn't count for a lot, though, did it? Okay, fine. So we have to get the castle. Please don't blow up the bomb. Okay, and I need to remember the fact that this actually doesn't fire very far. So let's try and get it in a nice building dense area so it can do more damage. And then fire! Oh, I missed! I missed! Oh no! Like soldiers just standing there with a shield. I don't see any bombs around it, so I think I'm just gonna have to try that again. And, not be so bad at the game. So let's run into these guys. Let's actually get the flamethrowers out as well. Deal with those guys quickly. Oh, the lawnmower is so cool. Oh no, I'm on fire! Fire! Let's see if I can pass. Fire the cannons! Fire! Well, yeah, I need to make sure I don't die. I know this is entirely possible. I just need to be better about it and not let them blow me up. I think if too many guys get underneath me. You know what? The fire is a bad idea. The fire is a terrible idea. Maybe I'll replace these flamethrowers with flak cannons. I think that would actually be better. So let's go ahead and remove these. And then for weapons, we're gonna use. Oh, sorry, not the flak cannon, but the shrapnel cannon. Is there anything else here? There's a water cannon, but why would you want that? Oh, there we go. Okay. Pop it like this. That should deal with those guys pretty well, I think. I'll put some on the side as well, just in case. Can I rotate it? There we go. I'm so glad I know how to rotate things now. Okay, and to fire these, I need to hit C. Okay, here we go. Flak cannons! Oh my gosh, that did so much damage, too. Nice. Okay, spinning blades will take care of these guys. Yeah, go ahead, just run up to the machine. Actually, let's get close to the castle here, and we'll fire the bomb. That really didn't do a lot of damage, did it? Am I gonna need two? Am I gonna need two catapults? That's pretty disappointing. Maybe I can actually just run into some of these buildings and destroy them. Let's go. Let's run into the buildings. Maybe that'll push me across the limit of what I need to complete this level. Come on! Did that even count for anything? I'm not even sure. This thing is actually huge! Look at it compared to this lighthouse. Windmill. Not lighthouse. Come on, just run into it! Try again! Get a bit of speed up, and it's not working. Oh wait, I've got my cannons. I missed with the cannons. I keep forgetting about the cannons. All right, let's go back a bit more. Angle it up. Okay, and two. Oh, I missed. Well, I can get the buildings that are on the ground easily enough. Let me get this one here. Okay, come on. I did count. It does count towards some credit, but I don't think it's gonna be enough. So let's try again. Should I make another catapult? That's hard to say. Maybe. Oh, you know what I could do? I can actually just put another bomb on this same catapult. I'll pop it right here. Something tells me this is a really bad idea. Let's make it longer. Because if I do it too close to here, it's just gonna go straight up and land on top of me. So let's make the arm as long as it can be. That appears to be about as long as it can go. Okay, and we're gonna use get some braces in here to make sure it's nice and strong. Like that, right here. Oh, that was really weird. And one here. Okay. Now let's see how many bombs we can get on this. Because if we have two bombs on it, it's more likely to do a lot more damage. So put one here, one here. Hopefully the strings are strong enough to actually fire two bombs. Let's test that out real quick. Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh. Don't do that. Oh, it just wants to blow up. Why? Why do you want to do this to me? Yeah, that's not gonna work. Is it gonna work with even just. You know what? I think it's because it's landing on the ground, actually. So let's put the bomb back, and we'll give it a little piece to land on. That's gotta be what it is. So have a little landing platform for it right here. Pop this here. Make sure it's nice and strong. Oh man, that was terrifying. Here we go. This should work. Yay! Okay, and fire! The string is not going. It's not going at all. Why is it not going? Is it just not strong enough now? Let's make it 5 times as strong. I could be doing this all just completely wrong here. 5 times stronger. Okay. And fire. It's too heavy. Is it getting stuck on this brace here? Do you see this? It's like attaching itself to the other brace. Let me move that brace here and see what happens. Well, okay. Oh, so dramatic. Fire! Okay, having two bombs is just the worst idea. One bomb? God, man, it's not good enough. Let's see how much we can undo. Let's have the catapult the original length. There we go. Nice. Because that one works just fine. It's not perfect, but it works just fine. We're just gonna have to do a better shot with the catapult when we get to that point. Let's do cannons, flak these guys up. Go. Keep forgetting I actually need to use two buttons to go forwards and backwards, and two buttons to turn as well. Okay, so let's start destroying some of these buildings here. I think mainly I need to make sure I can shoot the windmill with the cannons. Oh no, because the other ones I could just drive into if I need to. Yes. All right. Awesome. Actually destroyed two buildings. Let's go around to the other side. Why is this thing? Whoa, whoa, whoa! What are you doing? Why is my catapult doing this? That is really freaking me out. Okay, we're gonna go over here and we're gonna shoot the castle from another angle, so that we can do more damage. Oh my gosh, that thing is scaring me. Why are you doing this? I don't think undo actually changes the tensile strength on the springs. So those are still set to like 5 times, and it's really freaking me out the way that thing is toppling around. Okay. If I could destroy the tall tower on this castle and some of the inside walls, I think that might be enough. Okay. But not if I blow up. If I blow up, then it's all kind of pointless. Oh my gosh. This thing is so scary. Oh, come on. I need to get a little bit closer. Don't you bounce up. Don't you bounce up. Okay. Okay, I think that's close enough to fire. This is the worst catapult in the history of Besiege. Okay, here we go. What was that? Oh, the stupid thing. Okay, let's change this. Yeah, it's still, see, look at that. It's still on 5 times. It changed to 1 time. And this one back to 1. And I might actually start out with going straight for that side shot like I did last time, rather than fighting these guys, because they're just going to die as soon as they run to me. The lawnmower setup is actually pretty effective for dealing with ground troops. So I don't need to worry about those guys as much as I need to worry about destroying the castle. And if this doesn't work, then what we're going to do is we're going to make two more catapults in the place of where those cannons are right now, because I don't really need those for this level anyway. I could destroy most of the buildings by running into them. Okay, so we're going to go here like this. There's ground troops just following me. Okay, here we go. Oh, I pressed the wrong button. Here we go. It landed in the courtyard and it didn't destroy a single thing. Fine, that's it. I think I'm gonna do a fast forward here so I can build these extra catapults. All right, I have my three catapults made. This thing is nuts. Okay, we're gonna go try it again now. Hopefully this is gonna work. I'm wait for these guys to get closer. I'm gonna use my shrapnel cannons. Deal with them. Okay. Let's walk over them just a little bit. Oh, I gotta be careful that I don't set off my catapults. Okay. Now, let's make sure we don't mess this up. Hopefully this works. They're all set to fire on the same button, actually. Oh, that wasn't really very destructive at all, was it? Oh no. Maybe I can get enough credit from destroying these buildings here. Let's try this out. No, that's not gonna be enough credit. Okay, let's try again. But this time we'll do better with the catapults. Let's get rid of these guys here. Okay. Let's get nice and close to the building. Oof, gosh. Here we go. Fire the catapults! Oh, that was so much better than any other attempt. Hooray! Okay, so now I just need to make sure I keep together here. We'll destroy these last buildings. Yay! I'm gonna destroy the buildings anyway. Island destroyed. I think that's the entire island done. What are we looking at next? Oh, look at that. It's even destroyed on the map. Awesome. So the next one is gonna be Tolbrind. But unfortunately, I have run out of time for today, so I'm gonna have to tackle that one next time. Thank you very much for watching. If you liked it, please do give it a thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. And subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye!